Hello, Calvin Jones, Park Tool Company with Tech Tuesday. Today we're looking at the integrated headsets and the head tubes that hold them. The idea of a headset bearing is to have them aligned at the axis of the steering column so everything turns smooth and nice. If they're not, there will be binding as you rotate the column. On an unbuilt frame with the IS or integrated standard, here's a simple test that can help the mechanic determine if the head tube needs machining. Drop in the cartridge bearing. Put your fingers 180 degrees apart and rock them up and down. Notice the amount of jiggle or play. Now move to another point 90 degrees apart and see if it's the same. If you don't get the same jiggle, something's asymmetrical. This frame could stand some machining. The 756S is the reamer and facer for the IS41 integrated systems. We get some slight tension. We rotate. Here, we're machining the contact seat for the bearing. We're machining the diameter. And we're also machining the depth or height that the bearing sits inside the frame. And I bet we're probably pretty good. So release tension. Give it a slow spin to knock off any burrs. And we lift. It looks nice. Let's see if it feels nice. We drop the bearing in. Sure enough, there's play front to back. But left to right, there's an equal amount of play. It's that the play is even all the way around. That's what counts. The 45 degree contact below, that's what's going to take the pressure and keep our headset from having play and keep it from binding. So again, we're even with the rocking all the way around. We're rocking around the house evenly. This is a smooth and nice headset. That's it for Tech Tuesday. We'll see you next week.